Hi all, this is Papaya from Papaya Pythons, and we're going to talk about our sunbeam snake. So first things first, we need a nice clean tub. We have our little male in about a 5 or 6 quart, and then we add dry bedding to that. So we have sphagnum moss and coconut sort of shavings, coconut bark is what some people call it, but it's really fine. And you can see that's sitting in water. So the substrate is dry, and we let it sit in the water, and it's a little cool. But that's okay because we're patient. This is the cage he's in right now, the one that we want to take him out of, and you can see that the cool side is about 82. So after about 8 hours, or overnight, we measure the temperature of the new cage again. And this time, yeah, we're right about 80, which is great because we have belly heat, and so we don't want it to be too hot on top, otherwise it'll be way too hot on the bottom, which is where Apollo will spend his time. So these guys are really shy. We don't like to rush them. We reach in and take him out of his old cage, and then I just let him spend his time finding where he wants to be in his new cage. And I have tossed around the substrate so that it's kind of universally wet and a more universal consistency. And you can see as long as you're really gentle and slow, you can move these guys around. But see, he's taking those deep breaths because he's not sure. And ours are actually very tame. I mean, they never bite. Sunbeams just have really small faces. But we don't want to scare him because a lot of these species don't do well in captivity because of the stress of handling. So we try to keep it to a minimum, especially with our little male who tends to be a little nervous. And so we'll let him go back into his nice new dark house, and I'll fill up his water after he's buried himself under his new substrate. So another thing to really be cautious of with these guys is they're escape artists. So because of that flat shovel nose, they can get through spaces that most snakes can't. So this space here would not be okay for a sunbeam. But luckily for us, Ichabod is ball python, and he's not going to fit his fat snoot through that tiny space. You can see he likes his coconut. But you really can't underestimate the size of gap that they can get through. So you really need tubs that are going to fit almost precisely up against your rack. And Freya, our little girl who's in another video, she can show us another sunbeam enclosure. So she actually spends a lot of time on the top of the substrate, and I don't know if that's a male-female thing or if that's just her size or if she's just a more confident animal, but she has enough substrate to get in there, and you know, you can see it's the same coconut and sphagnum, and it's soaking wet. We don't like them on standing water, just they do really like their substrate wet. And we always keep a bowl of fresh water in case they want to drink and not have it full of coconut bedding. But you can see the fit on her cage is very, very tight. And one time I did change the cage and I put Apollo in one that had just the tiniest gap and I didn't think it was enough. And I found him crawling around outside of his house several hours later. So if you are going to keep these guys, make sure you think like a baby colubrid because they're that kind of escape artist. These are a really cool species. They're not that common though because they are very hard to keep in captivity. They're always wild caught, and we're working on a breeding program. Wish us luck. Thanks all.